friends of class 12. In this video, I am going to discuss informatics practices class 12, important questions and answers from the topic histogram. So let's begin. Myself Sanjay Parmar. I welcome you all on my channel tutorial AICSIP. So here we begin. So first part is there, objective type questions. So in these questions, you will get one mark questions in your question paper. So some of the questions I have prepared over here for you. So let me start. The first question is, a DAS is a tool that summarizes discrete or continuous data. So here, as the text says, summarizes discrete or continuous data. So that means a histogram. It is just a definition of histogram only. So the answer is histogram. Second, the numerical data shown by the number of data points that fall within a particular range is called dash. So the numerical data, so whenever we are representing the numerical data on histogram, it is considered as bins. We can say that it bins. So whatever numerical data is shown there by the number of data points and it is fall within the particular range, so that will be considered as a bin. Suppose range is there 25 to 50, 100 to 150, like that. Question 3. A histogram is similar to vertical bar graph. So here it is true or false. So it is true. It is almost like vertical bar graph. You can convert them into horizontal as well, but initially it is vertical bar graph. So that is true. Question 4. Which of the following data can be shown by histogram? So here the options are the quality like weight, height, time, etc. Then the categories, the uncountable data, all of these. So what type of data you can plot on histogram? So here you can plot the quantity, wherever you can put the quantity like weight, height, time, that can be plotted on histogram. So that is the correct answer. Then the histogram was introduced by, who introduced the histogram? Carl Pearson. So that is the name of the person who has introduced the histogram. Question 6. A dash function is used to create histogram. So a simple function is there, that is hist, H-I-S-T. So that you have to use. I will show you that part also when we will cover the long answer questions. How many parameters a hist function can have? Whenever you are writing, how many parameters it will contain? So the hist function contains 5 parameters. So 5 parameters you have to specify, but all are not compulsory. Some of them you can use as per the requirement. Question 8. A dash is a Boolean parameter of hist function, which is by default false. So that is cumulative, because cumulative is there whenever you want to display data in a cumulative form. Question 9. A dash parameter is used or just a number or series or arrays to be plotted on histogram. So the first parameter, so that is x. So x can be considered as a number or series or arrays. So that we are writing on histogram whenever you want to insert the histogram. Which of the following is traditional bar type histogram? So here options are given. X, that is x axis. Bins, bins are the numbers or series. Then hist type. So hist type is the correct answer. Traditional bar type. Okay, so that is hist type you can use. Hist type, that will be horizontal or whatever. Orientation. Orientation is not a type of histogram. Question 11. Which of the following parameter have values like horizontal or vertical? So here x will contain the range or numbers, whatever number you want to plot on histogram. Bins is also considered like range or numbers, whatever we want to use. Then hist type. Hist type contains the type of that, but it will not consist the value like horizontal or vertical. So there we can specify the histogram type. Orientation is there, so their orientation can be vertical or horizontal. Question 12. Which of the following is the correct statement to create a histogram with ND array x and bins value as 30? So here ND array, the array is given as x and bins value, that is 30. So that is given over here. So which one is the correct? So here option A, hist x bins 30. So here bins, then colon is given. So colon is not used here. because when you specify the colon, Python will consider as a dictionary, so that you cannot use colon. Second option, hist x comma bins equal to 30. So that will be the correct answer. Whenever you want to assign a value to any inbuilt parameter or any your user defined variable, you can use equal to. So equal to is used over here, so that is the correct option. Here minus is used, so that is the not correct option. And here three parameters are given, so that is also wrong. Bins you cannot use in this manner. The value should be specified. Question 13. A dash value should be specified to hist type to generate a line plot that is by default unfilled. So which value is there? That is unfilled. So that value we have to specify. So that is step value. Because when you use the step value, that means the hist type will be generated according to the line plot of by default unfilled. Means that will be not filled whenever we are using step value. Question 14. You cannot create horizontal stacked histogram. That is false. You can create stack histogram. Question 15. Which of the following is correct to generate horizontal stacked histogram? So here hist type should be bar stack and orientation equal to horizontal. So this is the correct way, because we need horizontal as well as stack histogram. So stack word should be used, and that is bar stacked. So that is the value of hist type. So that we have to specify over here whenever you want to use horizontal stack histogram. Other arguments are there, but those all are incorrect, because we cannot use horizontal as hist type and bar stack as orientation. Here horizontal, then orientation and landscape, that is also not correct. And option D, none of these. So that is wrong. Now some question answers. Describe the histogram, how to plot data on histogram. So here I have provided the link of notes. Students, you can prepare your answers in your language. Here I have provided some of the suggested notes. So those notes you can use. Just click over here, you will render to this page. Now the first question, see, describe the histogram, how to plot data on histogram. So that you can write from here. What is histogram? A histogram is a quite similar to vertical bar graph with no space in between vertical bars. So this sentence you can manipulate in your language, you can write in your language. When you have data which has data points fall between a particular range, you can use histogram to visualize this data. It is helpful to display statistical data or data inserted in measurable quantities. Example, marks, scores, units. It was first introduced by Carl Pearson. So whatever answer you feel, you can write in your language. Words would be used like this. Now creating histogram. So this is also given over here. To create histogram, Python hist function is used. The syntax of hist function, that you can write like this, and then you can explain if you want to explain, and if the question is asked in 3 marks or more than 3 marks. Otherwise, just write like this. Only the content you provide according to the question. Okay, so like that. Next question, explain hist function in detail. So here this answer will come. So you can write in your own language. Here I have given in this manner syntax, and then arguments I have explained. So here you can get these questions and answers. Question 3, clarify the situation when you need to use bar charts and when you need to use hist chart. So when you are going to use this, that you have to clarify. Simple thing is there, whenever you want to use some of the data or you want to plot some of the data which you want to compare. So for that comparing, we can use bar chart. Suppose if we consider one example, suppose one IPL match is going on. Now you want to compare the bowler's bowling spell, how many runs he has given. So there you can use bar chart, because bar chart is giving a separate chart for particular over. So in that you can use this thing. Second is hist chart. Now hist chart, when you can use, if you want to find out the runs he conceded and Madden overs he conceded, that time you can use hist chart, because it will be the continuous data. So whenever continuous data is there, you want to specify runs for each ball. For over, you can use vertical bar chart. And whenever you want to find out runs each ball, so in that case, you can use histogram. So these are the situations. Like that, you can use whatever situation you may feel. Question 4. What is the significance of cumulative histogram? Elaborate your answer with example. So, cumulative. So, here first you understand the use of cumulative. So, here I have explained. It is a Boolean value, either true or false. If provided true, then beans are calculated where each bean given gives the counts in that bean plus all beans for smaller values. The last bean gives total number of data points. The default value is false. So, whenever you are using cumulative, there will be difference in your histogram. So, how it will be done? Either you can specify true or you can specify false. So, whenever you are using this true or false value, it will just display chart something like this. Here you can see. So, this is histogram false by default. Because by default we are not using, so it is coming in this manner. Here you can see. And when we are using the histogram, hist type true, then the value will be something like this. It will come in this manner. Let me show you if I have added this hist type equal to true in this post here. Here it is. So here you can see, like this it is coming. So here you can identify the cumulative true value. If we are putting true value, then let me copy this code and I will show you the example. How it is giving the output. See, here we have used np random rand n. That function is used and we have generated numbers, random numbers from up to 100. 0 to 100 we can consider rand n. 1 to 100 also. Hist x, so that value will come 20, that is tab. Cumulative equal to true. So here true is used and age color blue, face color R. Now let me run this program. See, here it is coming in this manner. And when we are not using this parameter, you just observe the output, what happens. And you can understand this concept. F5. So it will come like this, straight. Okay, and when we are using hist type equal to true, it will go according to the bean's value or range, whatever range we have provided. So that is the difference. So I hope you understand this concept, how it is plotting the value and how it is displaying the histogram. So that is the meaning of cumulative. Then next, how to change the age color and color of histogram. That also used in this program. You can see here age color parameter is used, that you can specify any color or code. Here you can provide color code as well. Here I want to use G, green color. So now you can see the green color line is coming for each and every bar. So in that manner you can change, you can use either color code or color name. Explain the following parameters of hist function with example. Beans, hist type, orientation. So the answer is already provided in these notes. You can find out here and you can write from this solution, or you can provide, you can write in your language also, so that you can write. Next, question 7, how to save histogram as image. Whenever you want to save histogram as image, you have to use this thing. Let me show you, I have covered that point also. Here, see, saving the histogram as image. You can use save fig method to save the histogram. Consider the above example and add this line to the program. So at last you have to use this method. See, histo.png. So let me save this thing. m.savefig. And in this code, I will just paste that one. Invalid character. Okay. This is coming due to copy paste. Because when we are using copy paste from MS Word or browser, the characters change sometimes. Sometimes it will consider the same thing. Now here you can see, or another method is also there. This you can use, save the figure. So that will be also useful. Now let me check. So I have saved this program in D drive. So let me open D drive, Python histogram. Okay. So it is not saved over here. Where it is saved? Open the Python installation folder to view saved image. Yes. So there only it is saving at that location. So let me change the location. Otherwise you have to check there. App data, Python. wherever the Python installation is there. So just I am saving this file in D drive. So now let me close this and we are going to check in D drive. So here histo file is available and you can get the preview. Let it be open. It is taking time here. Okay, let me open with some other photo viewer. Open with, then paint. Okay, it is just blank image, I think. So maybe some problems are there, but the method is used, that is save m.savefig histo.png. So that will be used whenever you are using this method. The image will be saved as .png file. Whatever name we are giving, accordingly it will be saved. Then next question. Write code to plot the following data. So here some of the data is provided that we have to plot on the chart. So here I have created one L list object and all numbers are given as values. Now mp.hist L and mp.show. Whenever you want to plot some data, you have to use this method. First hist and then argument or parameter, whatever you want to give. After that, you can write the show method to display the values on chart. So here the output will be like this. The next question is generate random numbers from 1 to 70 and plot it on the histogram. Change the outline color to black and the bar color should be yellow. So here outline color should be black and bar color face color. Whenever you want to use bar color, that will be considered as a face color yellow. So here I have used only random function. So that's why this package is required. Import NumPy as np. NumPy is not is in their syllabus, but you might learn in class 11th. It was there whenever you are there in class 11th. Or if you don't know, then you can just go through about that NumPy, or I will provide you the solution for NumPy also. So x equal to np.random, then rand, n is a function which creates random numbers. Whatever range you are providing, in that range it will produce random numbers. And random numbers can be generated accordingly, according to your code, according to the system sometimes, and according to the random range. So that we have to provide here. Then hist x, then I have given 20, age color black, face color yellow. So these are the parameters. Now let me check. So whenever you want to use, because here they have given 1 to 70 and plot it on histogram. This 20 can be used as a width, or you can change the number as well, whatever number you need. So here F5. Now see, here you can see. So this is the histogram for this particular thing. Now black color is used as line color and the bar color is yellow color. Here you can see. Next question. Display the above data in cumulative mode. So only cumulative equal to true that you have to add. So let me remove this 20 first. So I will show you that also. Now cumulative. So here you can see cumulative equal to true. So it is coming in this manner. And the width also you can see it is changed. So whenever we are using the numbers, the width or the bars will be generated in this manner. See, suppose I am writing 50. So there will be some change. So that is used for that particular thing. Whatever numbers you want, you can use in that manner. So number of bars will be generated. Okay, so now next question. Write Python code to create histogram based on given data. So here two teams data is given like this, RCB, then some numbers are given, that is Royal Bangalore, then MI, Mumbai Indians. So here you can see RCB, that runs I have given in this list. Second list object is MI. And then I have used both of them and cumulative equal to true. So in this manner, it will compare both teams score. So here you can see, wherever the data is there, it will compare accordingly. 78, whatever runs are there, and it will compare. So in this manner also we can produce this data. If you are not using cumulative equal to true, then it will come in this manner. So just you change the parameter and observe. See here, now it is coming in this manner. So cumulative should be used so that it will compare with both of them, whatever data is available. Now, question 5, draw histogram for the following code. So here code is given, you have to draw the histogram. So it is almost similar like this. So now you can observe and you can draw as per your level. English and Maths marks are given. Orientation is equal to horizontal. So that horizontal will be drawn and then you can draw the chart. So I hope you understand the concept and you enjoyed this video. If you are enjoyed this video, click the like button, hit the like button and share this video with your friends. And if you are coming to my channel first time, watching my video first time, hit the subscribe button and press the bell notification icon as well. I am uploading contents for class 12, class 11th regularly on my YouTube channel. Thank you very much for watching this video. We will meet again with new video with new concepts. Till then, tata bye bye and keep watching, keep learning.